In 1998, Terry Clayton emerged as the champion of the Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. This year, he's back in the mix.
Welcome to Insight Communications, Cable Channel 13 for the 1999 Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. Hello, everyone. I'm Scott Gilmore. Joining me today, Doug Weedman, and we have an exciting field of eight, a lot of experience. As a matter of fact, two players from our championship match last year with Terry Clayton and Vinny Atria. Terry Clayton, our defending champion. It should be an exciting TV show.
Oh, without a doubt. We have a lot of players here who are all outstanding shot makers. We have former touring pros, former member of Team USA. I expect an outstanding final.
Well, the bowlers today went through a grueling qualifying session this weekend. Condition was tough. Explain to the viewers out there what kind of a condition we expect on the TV show and what kind of format we have here today.
Well, the conditions that we're going to have on the show is the same that grueling conditions that we've had all weekend long. The format, we're going to have three shootout rounds, and what's going to happen is that the winner of each shootout round will advance. And eventually they're going to meet the tournament director, or tournament leader, Gary Ness. I expect an outstanding finish to a very exciting tournament so far. We're ready to get started. Scott, go ahead, take it away.
We're ready to get halfway underway between Gary Swanson, Terry Clayton, and Dave Hurt. Should be an exciting first match here. We have a shootout of three. Three bowlers will bowl at the same time. Gary Swanson with his first shot, game one. Goes up high, crosses, leaving the 6-10. Ball a little tight. Nervous here early on. David Hurt, 1996 Team USA player, Doug. An exciting player here to watch as he makes his first shot, game one.
Oh, David, capable of a lot of quality shots.
Oh, and good, he trips carry out the 4-9 there for a strike.
What's my surprise?
Swanson will get the 6-10 and he'll convert. Fast-paced action here so far.
Yeah, with a three players in each round, bowling's going to be very, very quick. Players are going to be stepping up right away. One of the outstanding bowlers in the Lafayette area, and perhaps one of the outstanding bowlers throughout the Midwest, is Terry Clayton.
Well, Terry Clayton, he's our 1998 champion, returning here. He was the 8th seed. His first shot of game one. And he hits thin, leaving the 7th pin.
Didn't quite get that ball to roll up like he wanted to.
Gary Swanson here with his second shot. Got it in tight. And across Brooklyn, break for Gary Swanson.
Oh, without a doubt, that was a very big break. He's not quite swinging through the shot. Not giving it a chance to get down the lane.
Gary attempting his 7-pin spare.
Should be a fairly easy make for Terry.
And he does, converted. David Hurt will step up for his second shot here of this first match.
Dave's the former Team USA player that I mentioned in the intro. I've run across him a couple of times in some World Team challenges, and he's just a great shot maker.
Well, this is going to be a fast-paced show here. The three bowlers will be bowling. First one, and Dave with a nice shot there for a double early. He takes the lead of this first shootout round.
On a tough shot like this, one of the things you want to notice is how the players extend through the ball on their shot. That allows them to protect the ball through the heads and get it to a very consistent break point.
Well, Terry Clayton at the 7th inning pitch for a spring. He's here to strike to catch up with Dave Hurt. Ball comes in light, leaving the 2-pin. Didn't look like he caught all that one, Doug.
No, he's missed the release just a little bit. I think Terry's also a little bit tight. Not quite getting the hand around the ball, getting it to turn over to the left.
Gary Swanson coming up, crossing the brook, headpin three times, matter of fact, all three shots have either crossed or went through the nose, and he got fortune there to trip out the 10, leaving only the 5. And now Terry Clayton in the third, picking up his spare.
Spares across the middle were difficult all weekend long. Very hard to judge those. Corner pins weren't such a problem, but the 2 pins, the 4 pins, they were a little bit more tricky.
All right, Gary Swanson.
Good spare.
5 pin, excuse me, Terry made the 2 pin. As pace will be fast and furious here. Exciting though.
Without a doubt. I expect to see a lot of quality shots. And this guy is capable of quality shots.
Dave Hurt with a double here.
Great long swing.
Looks good. Boy, what a hook. And it does.
Ooh. Not quite.
A little weak 10 there, but Dave will take a pocket hit every time he can, you're expected to bowl to carry a high percentage, though, if you are in the pocket.
Oh, yeah. Especially a player like Dave, who has such a clean release at the bottom of his swing. He's going to create some good ball reaction and good pin carry.
Terry Clayton with a nice flush hit.
Dead in the hole.
Big shot for Terry Clayton as he goes spare strikes. Fair strike.
I've had the privilege of bowling and knowing Terry now almost 16 years, and he always amazes me.
And Dave Hurt going at his cross lane 10-pin. Converted easily. All these guys are tremendous fair shooters. As a matter of fact, they have to be, because the format was grueling and the condition was tough. And you know as well as anybody, you lost your eventual number one seed, Gary Ness, here in the final round of 16. And you know what it takes to make good shots on this kind of condition.
Oh, without a doubt. The condition is tough enough. If you make a small mistake, you can't afford to compound it with another. Got a break.
Watson with the messenger striking in the fourth frame.
Most of these players have very solid spare shooting technique, so they're not going to throw away pins needlessly.
Dave Hurt leading early here by 19. Spare up. And what, a shot on 17. And it wiggles a 10-pin, didn't get it.
A little disappointed in that one. He thought he made a pretty good shot on that one. One thing that makes this interesting is that a lot of players are playing a similar line. And so it's going to be interesting to see how the lanes break down and what kind of adjustments they have to make later on in the day.
Terry can cut it to 9 with a strike here. It comes up light, leaving the 2-8. He's going to have to make a little bit of adjustment on that lane as the ball seems to be going long for him. Dave will attempt to go cross lane at his 10-pin. Should convert easily. Uh-oh, that one's going to get in the channel, and he missed it.
That's almost an inexcusable error for a player of his quality. He's really kicking himself about that one. Open frame like that allows any of the other players to come back with a quick double and take the lead.
Well, that's put some pressure. That's big for the guy sitting on the bench, because they just take the lead while not even bowling, throwing the ball. And Terry easily makes it 2-8.
You don't want to give the player sitting down any more confidence than he needs. You always want to feel like they have to catch up.
Well, Gary Swanson here in the fifth. And it's Brooklyn once again. I tell you what, he's in the mask, but you don't like his line right now, I'm sure.
No, without a doubt. I just don't see him pushing the ball through the head. He just seems the ball wants to roll up early and quit at the back end. Either he needs to make a ball change or he needs to rethink the line he's playing on the lane.
Here's Dave Hurt. On an open.
A little tight.
Oh, and he gets it. Nice shot for Dave Hurt. As he needed that after missing a 10-pin and a 4.
It looked like he had come up light a couple of times, and then that one he squared it up a little bit, pulled it inside, and played a little stronger line to the pocket and sat right in there dead flush.
Terry Clayton in the fifth, working on a spare. And he trips him, hits him thin with a strike. So after 5 frames of bowling, Gary Swanson is leading by 11 here early in the Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. All right, welcome back to the 1999 Nirvana Family Restaurant Open here in Star Lanes. And tight match it is, as Gary Swanson leading here by a small amount, about 11-10 to be exact. He's up here in the 6th frame working on a double, and he's probably the one that really doesn't have a good line so far here in this match.
Yeah, we're waiting to see if he makes an adjustment here.
And his first frame, he goes once again cross, leaving the 9-pin. And now, hoping to convert that to maintain his lead of 10.
One of the things I was really interested in is just before we cut away to break, I saw the change in the way Terry rolled the ball, got it back up to the pocket. So he may get it lined up right about now.
All right, Dave Hurt working on a strike in the fifth, trying to cut that lead down to 10. And he does with a beautiful shot there from David Hurt. He doubles, and he is right back in this match, down 2. Swanson will attempt at his 9-pin, and he makes it. He looks to be short on the ball a little bit, Doug, and explain to the viewers out there what we mean by short on
it. Well, what happens is that we don't finish the swing. We don't get the hand through the ball at the bottom of the swing. Our tendency is to get a little bit tight, and that has a tendency to make the ball sit a little short and hook up a little bit early. He's got a loosened arm swing.
All right. Terry Clayton with a strike in the fifth, 79, score in the fourth, needing a double here, staying back. Comes up light once again on that right lane, as lane 18 has been baffling him so far in his championship match. Gary Swanson here in the seventh. Trips him out. I don't know what hit the four pin there, but what a break for Gary Swanson as he needed that.
And that's the first ball of the match. I think he's gotten to the right of the head pin.
Good call there, Doug, as Terry will step up to try to convert the 2-4. That's so easily. And he'll stay in the match as well.
He's a little mystified by lane 18 right now. I thought he felt that he made a good shot and was going to come up back to the hole. Didn't quite make it there.
All right, David Hurt in the seventh frame, down 12 to Gary Swanson, who's leading this. Strike here will bring it back to 2. All right, down the left, looks good. Oh, almost maybe the 4-9. I don't know if you call that a break tripping out the 4-pin, but the 9-pin will stand. And Dave Hurt will trail by 3 here in this match.
Looked like he might have gotten that one a hair slow, and he jumped up on it.
Terry Clayton, up in the seventh, on a spare. Nice ball as he switches the head pin back across. Big strike for Terry Clayton, our defending champion.
You thought lane 17 figured out. If he can get a better roll on 18, it'll be interesting.
All right, Dave Hurt beat Tony Phillips with a score of 652 to 645 to advance to the TV show as he picks up the ninth pin. And he had to convert the bucket in the first ball in his spare attempt in the 10th frame to make the TV show.
Yeah, we had a lot of very close finishes getting in there. A lot of people had to really perform under pressure to make this final.
Gary Swanson will stand up here in the 8th, working on a strike, a big double here if he can convert. Looks good. No, comes up light, leaving a 2-4-8. And Gary is a little bit lost, even though leading in this match, he's received several good breaks.
Yeah, I think what's happening is that he knows he wants to get the ball right, and as he pushes the ball down the lane, he doesn't get the hand around it, and the ball just never rolled over for him.
All right, Dave Hurt stepping up here in the 8th, working on a spare. Trailing in this match to Gary Swanson, needing a strike here. And once again, he leaves that stubborn 4-pin, and he's not happy about it whatsoever.
Yeah, bowlers get frustrated when they make quality shots, and they can't quite get the carry they need.
Always want rewarded, don't they? And Gary Swanson will convert the 2-4-8, and he'll maintain his slight lead over Dave Hurt and Terry Clayton as we're getting ready to step up here into the 9th frame, crunch time. Dave Hurt, a 1996 Team USA member, finished 5th in the National Amateur to qualify for Team USA as he picks up his 4th pin. A lot of experience in this field. He's been bowling for 30 years, 10 300 games, and a career high set of 835.
And talk about career 300 games, 21 by Terry Clayton.
That is phenomenal. This man is as good as it comes under pressure as he won last year's match over Vinny Adrian.
Will it roll?
And it's a dandy shot. As Terry Clayton is within 10 pins of...
Very important. He struck on 18. He's going to finish on 17.
All right, Gary Swanson. Nice frame. What a strike and a big one it was. Maintain that 10-pin lead over Terry Clayton. Terry can step up in the 9th frame with a strike and take the lead in this match. Big shot here for Dave Hurt in the 9th frame.
See how Dave gets ready? He's getting the body ready as well as the mind. And now he's focused.
All right, and the release here in the 9th. Looks good so far. Oh, and it finishes. Oh, and a 9-pin. He can't believe it. That is 2 9-pins and 2 4-pins he's left so far in this first.
He is not getting rewarded for quality shots, without a doubt. Some people say bowling's a little bit unfair, but you've got to take your hits, the good ones and the bad ones.
A lot of money these players are bowling for. First place, $1,300 this year. And Terry Clayton in the 9th, a big shot. My, oh my, he does it again.
Got the chip off the wall.
He takes a 10-pin lead in this match. I tell you what, he is phenomenal here when it comes to bowling in the late frames of a game.
Yeah, Clayton really knows how to get his focus and really knows how to turn it on. Outstanding player.
All right, Dave Hurt will attempt to make his 9-pin conversion. He's probably bowling about as good as anybody has in his first championship round match.
Dave has a tremendous amount of experience, and you know he's not going to throw a match away. Every shot's going to be quality.
Here's Gary Swanson stepping up the 10th, working on a strike, and he needs his first one here in the 10th. Been bowling 12 years, owner of Shawnee Lanes in Attica. This big shot for Gary.
Will it bend? Nope. That's what we call throwing it past the break point. Pushed it right down the lane.
Well, he leaves the seven-count spare here is attempting the first ball in the 10th. Big spare conversion here for Gary Swanson to stay in this match. Gary Clayton in the driver's seat right now, if you want to talk about it. Empty first ball in the 10th.
Trouble.
Oh, he left it out. This ball almost went to gutter, forcing it to really get 8 on that ball, Doug.
Yeah, that was too bad. After all those quality shots, he just finally lost it on one. That happens on occasion.
Swanson,
nice try.
Misses the 10th pin as the head pin went wrapped around. It looks like Gary Clayton should advance in this tournament to move on. And they will attempt to convert the 1-2. Does so.
That's what he wanted on the first ball.
Well, basically, Terry needs to just get a good count on the first ball, and he's got this first match wrapped up.
Yeah, I expect Terry to make a very nice, confident shot here. I'll try to do a whole lot with the ball.
And his first ball in the 10th to win this first round comes up light, leaving the 2-8. So a little bit of work left here to do for Terry Clayton.
Yeah, the ball did a little double bounce as he set it down. I think he came off his hand a little faster than he'd like, and of course, he didn't get the lift that he wanted.
That is enough to win this first match. So Terry Clayton will advance. We also want to thank our sponsors for this tournament, especially Nirvana Family Inn Restaurant, Holiday Inn, Dean Hartford Vigorous Specialties, Awards Unlimited, Doug Anthem Shell, Mr. Pinson, Cool Corals, Davies Auctions, Star Grooming, Electro Lab, Steel Rods TV Shop, and Schroeder Jewelry. Without those people, we would not have this tournament possible. And also want to thank AMF as they kicked in a lot as well.
A lot of generous sponsors out there to make this day happen.
Well, Terry Clayton will win the first match. We just don't know what his final score is. Dave Burke finished with 200. Gary Swanson ended his day at, I believe, 197. Yes, it was. So Terry with a strike here could have 217. We'll win the match comfortably. So Dave Burke will finish his payday with $255. Gary Swanson will finish with 200. And Terry will move on. And his fill ball. That pesky fourth in the defense game. So he'll win the first match. 216 over Dave Hurt's 200 and Gary Swanson's 197. Let's take a break and we'll come back with the tip of the week sponsored by AMF.
Hi, my name is Ron Hicklin. And today I'm going to talk about three different types of cover shots. The first cover stock I'll be describing to you is the plastic cover stock. Plastic cover stock is typically a harder surface used for spare shooting and extremely dry lane conditions. The next type of cover stock I'll be talking about is the reactive cover stock. This is the one used by majority of bowlers today. Used for medium condition, gets you extreme length and a lot of back end. Last cover stock is proactive cover stock. Proactive cover stocks incorporate a particle in the ball which makes the ball roll extremely early. This also helps to yield better strikes on earlier lane conditions. So three types of cover stocks that we went over today, the plastic, the reactive, and the proactive. If you have any further questions, visit your local pro shop, and that's your tip of the week.
All right, welcome back to the 1999 Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. Our winner of the first match, Terry Clayton, defeating David Hurt and Gary Swanson, and Doug Weedman has caught up with our tournament leader, Gary Ness.
I'm standing here with tournament leader Gary Ness. And one of the interesting things about this format is that you have to wait quite some time before you get a chance to throw the ball. What adjustments and accommodations are you going to have to make?
Well, during practice, I didn't throw the ball very good on this pair, so I'm just going to watch and see how the other lefty bowls. I didn't kind of worry about who I have to bowl because there's all great players left, and it's not going to be easy.
So he does have to wait around a little while. Hopefully things will start falling. We'll see what's going on. We're back to Scott.
All right, we're going to get the second championship round ready here between Steve Stoller, Matt Rinkenberger, and Terry Clayton, who won the first match. And I tell you what, we got a lot of talent here. Matt Rinkenberger, an Indiana State collegiate player. He has a high set of 814 and 18 career 300 games, and that is a bunch. And also Steve Stoller, he's been bowling for quite a long time. He has a career high of 2,300 games in his first time in his second match, and he trips out the 6-10. Big shot for Steve Stoller starting out this second championship shootout.
Yeah, we have an interesting contrast in styles. We've got a power player, a and Rinkenberger, and then we also have a very slow, steady player in Steve Stellan.
Nice combination of lefties and righties. You know, one side didn't dominate over the other.
No, the only players who dominated were those who made quality shots.
All right, Terry Clayton coming up wide on lane 18, leaving the 2-8. He's left that several times, kind of shaking his head, not understanding exactly what the lanes are doing out there. His condition is demanding. Rinkenberger's first shot on 17. Now it comes up white, and he'll leave the 2-10.
I saw a lot of those this weekend. A lot of times where you expect the ball to turn over and it doesn't quite make it. A lot of buckets, two-pin combinations.
All right, Terry Clayton will step up to try to convert the 2-8 spare. Great spare shooter he is. Oh, and he missed it as he chopped the ball. Ball went by the 8 pin. So Terry Clayton opens here in the first frame. And if you really, you don't want to open, but this is a good time to do it.
Yeah, do it early, collect your thoughts, and then, you know, start making some more quality shots.
All right, Matt missing the 2-10. So two players have opened, giving Steve Stoll an opportunity to take a big early lead here. He's got a strike working the first in the second frame. Good looking shot here from that left hand. Oh, hooks up heavy, and he'll leave the 4-6-10. As players are maybe a little nerves taking effect here.
Yeah, this, you know, we got a lot of quality players, but a television finals is unique for a lot of these athletes.
As you look over the left shoulder of Terry Clayton is Spiro Moises and Holly Conrad. Holly's the owner of Star Lanes, and Spiro is the owner of the family restaurant, who has donated $1,000 into the prize fund. What a wonderful sponsor he is, and we are proud to have him on board.
And Terry made a great shot there, just didn't get a break. Solid 9.
And Steve, Terry picks the 10 off the 6. So he has it open here in a second, and players are a little nervous here early, trying to figure out the lanes, as the camera lights do affect the condition and is applied on the surface of the lane.
Yeah, I got a chance to talk to Terry before we got started. He says they do make the lanes change a little bit faster than you might expect.
All right, as Terry makes his spare. And Matt Rinkenberger, who split in the first, leaving the 2-10, stepping up here in a second, needing to get something working here. He gets the ball out a little bit. He wants the ball to stay out. It does. Leaving the 1-2-4-5.
Had a little bit too much trust on that one.
And Steve Stoller will step up here in the third, working on open. And he throws a flush. And he's thrown two wonderful shots on the left lane. And he'll take an early lead here. And Rinkenberger will attempt, and he leaves the 4th pin. So two opens for Matt Rinkenberger here as he's struggling early on here.
He's by far the youngest player in our final. And I think maybe he might be more affected by nerves than anybody else out here.
Terry Clayton with a spare working in the second. He won our first match over David Hurt and Gary Swanson. He shot 216. David Hurt shot 200 and Gary Swanson 197. So Terry, a lot of experience on TV as he won last year's title. Looking to repeat here in 99. And a beauty shot it was. Plus 10 in the pit for Terry Clayton. And he'll take a 3-pin lead over Steve Stoller here early in the second shootout round.
If Terry keeps on making shots like this, these guys are going to have to get lined up in a hurry.
Well, Matt with a double open, 17 in the second, working in the third frame. Nice shot as he sends pins bouncing everywhere. He gives a little wry smile, thinking, hey, I finally threw a strike here.
Kristen Vandish being young and strong.
He's a good player from Indiana State. They have a phenomenal bowling team down there with Steve Kinder and Jay Bridges and Scott Scheimer.
Nice extension.
Star coming up. That lane might be hooking a little bit. Is that ball he thought was good, but went through the nose, leaving the 6-pin unfortunate just to leave that?
Yeah, it was, but he let go of the ball. He had a nice extension. He got the ball down the lane. I thought it was going to hold line.
Well, Terry Clayton stepping up with a strike in the third, looking to double to increase his lead to 23. And it steps up, looks good, and he sends him spin. Watch him spin as he knocks down the 10 late. Terry Clayton with the first double of this match, and he's taking the lead here. And you're right, Doug, these other players are going to have to get lined up.
One thing about a player, when he starts loosening up, you'll notice he'll get better carry, because the ball's coming off the hand so clean. And the heavy ball roll will really kick the pins around.
As you watch Terry Clayton, or Steve Stoller, made his 6-pin spare, Matt Rinkenberger will step
step up here in the fourth, working on a strike and needing a double here to cut into that lead of Kerry Clayton. Trailing by 22 to get 12. All look good.
Nice ball.
Stone 10 pin is what we say as the 6 pin wrapped up around the 10, leaving it tough break for Matt.
That was a good quality shot, though.
You like the fact that you finally threw it in the pocket there on that right lane. And Stoller gets one out wide. Ooh, leaving the 1-3-5. Not a good shot there from Steve Stoller, the lefty.
Yeah, he leaned a little bit on that one and pushed it way too wide.
Matt will step up and convert the 10 pin easily. So that deficit will creep up to 23 behind Terry Clayton, our leader so far this shootout round.
Steve just needs to collect his thoughts a little bit, make a good quality shot, not necessarily an easy spare.
Stoller will attempt the 1-3-5, and he'll miss the 5-pin, so another open here in the fifth for Steve Stoller. Want to thank sponsors once again, Awards Unlimited, Doug Anthrop Shell, Mr. Fence at Cool Corals, Davies Auctions, and Star Grooming. Without their help, we could not make this event possible. We want to can't emphasize how important those sponsors are to a bowling tournament. And Terry Clayton with a double working here in the fifth to take a 33-pin lead. Oh, and he does.
He's feeling
Terry
good.
Clayton, he is lined up, Doug.
Oh, he is feeling good right now. You can see it as soon as he let go of the ball. You can see in his reaction that he feels like he's made a quality shot.
Well, he has taken a commanding lead here. Matt Riegelberger in the fifth frame working on a spare. Needs to strike. Oh, the ball creeps up through the nose, forcing it to leave only the 3-6-10.
I didn't quite see the whole shot, but I think he pulled up on it a little bit. Didn't quite stay down with the shot. And anytime you pull up, anticipating the hit on the ball, it's going to roll up early.
Well, Matt will attempt this 3-6-10 spare. Needing it to stay alive in this match, Terry Clayton is threatening the ball. This may be wide open. This ball needs to hook, and it does. Barely getting it. So after 5 frames, Terry Clayton leads by 33 pins over Matt Riegelberger and Steve Stoller. We'll be back right after this. All right, welcome back. We're in the 6th frame here. Terry Clayton has opened up a 33-pin lead over Matt Riegelberger and Steve Stoller. And Steve Stoller with an open here in the 5th, 72 is his score. He is in a must-strike situation here early on in this match.
Oh, without a doubt, because Terry's feeling very, very confident.
Okay, Steve Stoller stepping up here. Shot looks good. And it is a good result as he swishes it with a strike in the 6th frame, and a big one it was, Doug.
Oh, yeah. Strike like that, he gets some confidence back. He feels like he can come back and still make a good shot.
All right. Terry Clayton with a commanding 33-pin lead here. Steps up to make this baby 43 in the 6th frame. 3-bagger working. Oh, it's going to go to the nose. Oh, no. 4-6-10.
That potentially can make a big change in the match right here.
Looks like he's kind of a little soft with that, Doug. As Matt Riegelberger will step up here in the 6th frame, working on a spare in the 5th. Needing a strike. Ball looks good off the stick. Oh, wow. Yo, Doug, he almost left a 4-7-10 on that.
Yeah, that was a high pocket 4-7-10 just about. Just turns into the fast 8. He's disappointed, without a doubt. That was a good shot.
Terry to get 2, I'm sure. Yes, goes for the pin count, takes off the 6-10. Matt Riegelberger's father is right over here above my last, past my left shoulder, and we're watching him in the qualifying rounds, and he was as nervous as people can get as Matt converts the 4-7. I had never seen a father as nervous as Matt's father was. You would think he was out there bowling for him.
Well, they always say it's tougher to watch.
Well, he's excited for him to be on this championship field, and we are too, as Steve Stoller will step up working on a strike here in the 7th frame.
Let's see if he can make another quality shot.
He struggled on this left line. Nice shot, wrapped the 7th pin. And I tell you what, he struggled with carry when we had the 3-game total pin qualifying match.
Yeah, he doesn't have a whole lot of ball speed, so he really has to trust the ball to roll up and hit flush. He made a quality shot. He's thrown 2 good balls now. And unfortunately, just didn't get the carry he wanted.
All right, Steve Stoller will go at the 7-pin spare. Ooh, whoops. He misses it left. Throws it in the channel, and a big open for Steve as he's gone strike open, spare open, strike open. He's got an even 100 in the 7th. Terry Clayton, 114 in the 6th. Leading by 23. Looking to extend it.
OK. Got it.
Looks good as he is lined up on lane 18.
Yep, without a doubt. He's, as soon as it came off his hand, I've seen him throw the ball all the time. They look great.
Well, Matt Rinkenberger working on a span of 6 here to 7, needing to strike to get some momentum going here. And he does. Beauty shot there by Matt Rinkenberger, junior at Indiana State University. One fine collegiate bowler, too, as well.
Well, let's see if Steve can make a quality shot here. Finish off good.
With any chance of staying alive, he need, and this one's way out left. That ain't going to come back from there. So he leaves the 1-3. And Steve Stoller is struggling.
Yeah.
Not only physically, but it looks to be struggling mentally as well.
Yeah, he looks a little bit out of sync. He got tapped on the 10 pin, which he really thought he deserved, and then missed it, and that really deflates the bowler.
All right, Terry Clayton stepping up here. Strike looking at 7. Can really put a hurting on the rest of these two players. Oh, and a good one it was here in the 7th. In the 8th frame, a double now as Terry leads by 33 pins.
He had a bit of a quizzical look on his face. The other pin, he didn't quite like it off the hand, but it was great at the pocket.
All right, Steve Stoller converts the 1-3. Matt Rinkenberger, 92-6 with a strike in the 7th. The double here will cut that lead down to 23 pins, and he has to strike right here.
Without a doubt. We're getting to the late stages here, and he's got to do something to keep applying pressure to Terry.
You got to force Terry to continue to strike, and the only way you can do that is strike yourself. So a big shot here from Matt. Working in the 8th, strike in the 7th. Oh, and he got it. It looked like he was going to leave the stone 9, and the head pin comes flying back across and knocks it up. Big shot for Matt. And now that forces Terry to continue to strike. Steve Stoller finishing out here in the 9th frame, spare working in the 8th. And he throws a strike there, and...
Keeping a wise
gesture there from Steve Stoller.
Keeping a good attitude about it. He's made a fine run this tournament. Bowled outstanding.
Terry Clayton with a double here. Working on a double in the 9th frame. Strike here will increase his lead back to 32 pins.
A little short.
Oh, and it was dandy shot for Terry Clayton. As he leads by 32 here. 3 bagger now through 9 frames. Well, Matt has to strike here to have any hopes.
Yes, without a doubt. He's a young college player. Doesn't lack confidence, that's for sure.
Well, we have fun with the Indiana State team. Me, myself, and a dandy shot from Matt. Excuse me. Big 3-bagger for Matt as he cuts me back to 23. Well, I bowl for Purdue University, and we have a good time with Matt's team at Indiana State. I'd say there's an underrated aspect of bowling is the collegiate ranks.
Come on.
And Steve with a hit him thin, watching him spin strike.
Yeah,
so he now has a double.
Yeah, he's finally loosening up.
Well, you know about the collegiate ranks. You were a collegiate bowler yourself at Purdue University.
Yeah, from 1984 to 1980, I bowled collegiately. It's a great opportunity to learn a lot about the game, to bowl all over the country, to get experience in different tournament formats. Wonderful experience.
Well, this could pretty much show this matchup, first ball to 10 for Tick. Well, it comes up light, leaving a 2-8, and now Matt Rinkenberger has a chance.
He has an outside chance. This is not an easy spare to make this tournament. I believe Terry missed one already, this 2-8.
Terry leading by 20. And Steve will throw another strike here in the 10th.
Right now, Steve is wishing there was 15 frames in the game, because now he's throwing the ball sweet.
His last 3 or 4 shots have been very good. Terry Clayton needing to convert this 2-8. Matt Rinkenberger with an opportunity.
Will it make it?
Yes, it will. So Terry could strike in the 10th in his fill ball to shoot 212.
Learn from his mistakes. The last one he tried to go a little bit too straight at the 2-8. That one he gave it room.
This is a big shot for Terry Clayton, because if he strikes, that forces Matt to throw all three in the 10th to tie. So we have a possibility of a tie score here.
Now, in this situation, if we do have a tie, will both players advance and we have a 4-player finish?
No. We'll have a 10th frame. We'll have a best ball tiebreaker format, which whoever has the most pins in each ball, and they will continue to do so until they, you know, whoever wins that tiebreaker format. Terry Clayton eating off, and he gets it. So a huge fill ball here. So here's our scenario. Matt Rinkenberger, all three in the 10th, tie game. And then he'll have a face-off with Terry Clayton. Anything less, Terry moves on.
He needs to execute with great confidence. He got it out.
Looks good, though.
Oh, and it is a dandy shot from Matt Rinkenberger. So he cuts that lead down to 20.
The thing about the high rev players is they never feel like they're out of it. They always feel that they can string it.
So we have a best ball tiebreaker format here in case Terry and Matt do tie. What we mean by that, Tom, is each player will throw one ball. Whoever has the most at the one shot will move on. If they tie, they'll continue to do so until they have a winner.
That's a lot of pressure.
Sure.
Shot after shot.
It looks good off his hand, Doug. And it is.
Beautiful shot.
I tell you what, Matt has shown the ball as about as good as you can here in these last five frames.
Oh, with the pressure that he's under and he knows he's got to come back, he knows that every shot has to be quality. And he's throwing all of them right there when he needed to.
Oh, how big was that 2-8 left by Terry Clayton?
Yes.
Leave the door wide open for Matt. Come in here and sneak in and possibly tie this match up.
He may be young, but he's got some skills and he's got confidence.
Oh, here it is. Strike, the tie, anything less, he loses. Good.
Will it turn?
Oh, no.
Didn't quite turn.
Comes up light, leaving the 2-10, and what a final match as Terry Clayton sneaks by 2-12, defeating Matt Rinkenberger's 2-10. Wow, what a second championship round.
That was exciting for me, and I never touched the ball.
It was probably best we're over here, Doug. So we'll be right back with the third shootout round right after this. All right, welcome back. And what an exciting shootout round we had as Terry Clayton defeated Steve Stoller and Matt Rinkenberger, 212 to 210 to 178. And Matt Rinkenberger needed strike to tie Terry Clayton. He got 8, and Doug has caught up with Matt.
Made a lot of quality efforts to, quality shots to get back into that match and give Terry Clayton a little bit of a scare. I bet you want that last ball back.
Yeah, I'd give anything to give it back, but first time being on camera, I stepped up there, I was a little nervous, saying I just kind of buckled. I got it out too far, and it didn't come back, and I'm going home with the check, so it's fine with me.
Yeah, without a doubt, you had an outstanding tournament this weekend. Congratulations. We're ready to move on to the next match. Let's see what we can do. Go ahead, Scott.
All right, we're going to do a top 24 rundown. And 24th working on down to 9, Larry Pelfrey. In 23rd, Jeff Bowman. In 22 is Ty Stinson. Richard Ray in 21st. Number 20 was Mike Patterson. In 19th was Jeff Circle. 18th was Eric Kingman. 17th was Dave Vitato. Also finishing in the top 16 but failed to advance to the TV show was Doug Weedman, Jerry Schultz, Joe Moulton, Dennis Bergendorf, Steve Hartman, Skip Patterson, John Bauer, and Tony Phillips. Plus, we also want to thank our sponsors once again for making this TV show possible: Dean Hart's Refrigerated Specialty, Schrader's Jewelry, Holiday Inn, Steel Rod CB Shop, The Electrolab, Awards Unlimited, Doug Anthrop Show, Mr. Fincett, Cool Corals, Davies Auctions and Star Grooming, and plus the Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. And we're ready to start the third shootout round between Vinny Atria, Mark Sullivan, and Terry Clayton. And Doug, it was interesting to hear you talk to Matt, as he said he was about as nervous as he has ever been in one shot.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, he's a young player, and, he's got a lot of years ahead in this game.
I expect him to be back next year in our TV field, as he'll walk out of here with a winner's check of, a check at least of $400. As Vinny Atria with his first ball strikes, and I tell you what, this guy is about as good as it gets.
Without a doubt. What the viewers need to watch is see the way he sets up. He sets up his feet, he gets the body comfortable, he gets the ball set up, and then he just executes shot after shot. Just a craftsman at the game.
Oh, Mark Sullivan here with his first ball of this third shootout round. Oh, he comes up through the nose, leaving the 3-4-6-10 or 7. And he was a little soft with that, but these players don't get an idea of how much it changes here on the championship here. They only get 3 shots on each lane before the match starts.
Yeah, most of the rounds we had 10 or 15 minutes of warm up. 3 shots isn't quite enough.
And with the camera lights, as Terry Clayton strikes in his first ball of this third match, the camera lights will affect the condition. They will dry out because of the heat, so players will be moving left or right depending upon if they're right hand or left hand.
Right. And Terry has an advantage in that sense.
Mark Sullivan attempts to make a spare and chops off the 6 pin.
The person who is bowling game after game can see the changes in the conditions. so Terry will have an advantage. It's tough to walk in here almost stone cold and make a good shot on a tough lane condition.
Well, thanks to those wonderful sponsors we do have, we had $5,600 in the prize fund this year, which is an incredible amount for just your local average tournament, but we don't consider this an average tournament, is we?
No, you look at the quality of the field out here, these aren't average players.
Oh my, a stone 8-pin, as many threw a flush, and that's, you know, as a bowler and myself as well, those pins are what really annoy us. When you throw a great shot, you expect to leave the corners, but those 8s and 9s, you just don't expect to leave.
Yeah, most of the pins that are left standing on quality shots, you can explain, but the 8s and the 9s, they're just...
All right, Mark Sullivan, well, strike after a spare in the second, or open in the second, so... A much needed strike for Mark Sullivan is you do not want to get too much of a hole, especially as you're saying right now you got a field of favorite is Terry Clayton.
Yeah, Terry's got a good line to the pocket, he's feeling confident.
All right, Benny will go with the snare and he'll convert the 8 pin. So he has strike spare. Terry Clayton looking to take an early 10 pin lead here.
Benny has great self control. He won't let that 8 pin bother him, he's not happy about it. He'll come back with another good shot.
Well, here's Terry working on a strike in person early on in this third championship shootout match. And he leaves what we call almost at the Greek church, but the 10 pin falls late. So not a good shot there from Terry Clayton, the 4-6-7-9.
No, that one didn't come off his hand very well. You could hear the way it hit the lane. He set it down short and they just hooked up on it.
Also want to thank AMF for joining board, as each player that made the TV show is wearing a Nighthawk shirt provided by AMF. We'd like to thank them for that as well. And the winner will receive an AMF Nighthawk bowling ball as Vinny Atreus strikes in the third. And he'll take the lead. Actually sitting on the bench after Terry left that big four split. So you always like to see that as you're an opposing player to take the lead on the bench.
And Vinny has not missed the pocket yet. He has made... good use of his warm-up balls, and he's dead in the hole. So other than a stone 8, there's no flaw in this game right now.
Mark Sullivan will step up here with a strike in the second, needing a double here to stay up with Benny Atria. That's good, and almost a stone 9, but the head pin comes flying off and knocks out the 9 pin. And I'm noticing something here. The balls are almost getting too hard. They are going so far down the lane, they're building up so much friction. And you might want to explain to the viewers out there what friction with the equipment is, and they're hitting so hard on the back end.
Well, the bowling balls that they have now, they skid on the oil, and then they retain so much energy that when they do hit the dry, they rev up, almost jump at the pins.
As Terry Clayton comes back with a strike after his open in the second.
A lot of the players are playing the outside line, and once the ball starts to roll, it's going to have a tremendous angle in the pocket anyway. And you take the high-powered equipment, they almost do hit too hard.
Benny Atria with a 3-pin lead here can extend it to 13 in the fourth frame. This ball is going to go long, and uncharacteristically for Benny, that was just a bad release.
Yep, looks like he just didn't get up and threw the ball at all.
Well, he leaves the dreaded 2-10, what we call a half washout. Mark Sullivan with a double to take the lead, and he comes up almost leaving the 7-10 through the nose, but knocks the 10 out late, leaving the 7-pin.
This is not your typical league lane condition where you can make a mistake like Vinny made. You had to be firm and crisp on every shot. If you leaked it out a little wide, lots of 2-pins, lots of washouts, very tough lane condition.
Well, Vinny would attempt to make this washout split, almost misses the 2-pin, and he'll walk out with an 8-0 in the fourth frame, so... Nobody really taking control early on in this match. Just Sullivan will go out for the 7-pin and he makes it. So Vinny with the lead is now trailing in this match by 12.
In close matches like this, every open frame really is magnified.
Well, Terry Clayton down 20. Cut the deficit from Mark Sullivan. It's down to 10 with the strike here. Working on one and looking to double here. Oh, good shot, but that pesky 4-pin that really was the enemy of David Hurt in the first shootout round, as he left 3 4-pins.
I'm not doubting at this point that the lanes may start breaking down. We've seen a stone 9, we've seen a 4-pin. Players are going to have to make some subtle adjustments either with their feet or with their ball choice.
But here is Vinny Sullivan, or Vinny Atria in the fifth frame. And Vinny hits him thin, watch him spin as he gets a strike.
Little shaker off the wall.
Big shot for Vinny Atria as he retains that deficit to 12 pins here. Mark Sullivan. And Terry Clayton makes his spare.
The tricky thing about this shot is that if you do try to point it, you'll have a hard time carrying the high hit. So you want to keep it light, but it's so easy to get too light, just a fraction off, and then you leave the two tens and things like that.
A lot of scoring error for me. It won't be my first, I'm sure, or my last. My last, I should say, is Mark Sullivan strikes. Vinny is only trailing by 10 pins in this match to Mark Sullivan.
In the round of 16, I was crossing on the same pair of pins when I was going against Gary Ness, and he threw a lot of great shots.
Well, Terry Clayton stepping up here in the fifth frame, working on a spare, needing the strike here to put some pressure on everybody else. Almost got a break there, tripping up the two pin, but he'll leave that here as he is trailing by 23 pins.
Right now, I think Terry needs to take a deep breath, got this spot again. He's a quality player.
Yeah, you're only in the fifth frame. There's really no need to panic here.
No. Just need to get comfortable again.
All right, he's going to attempt to make this two-peg conversion, trailing 21 in the match. He makes it with ease. So after five frames, Vinny Atria, Mark Sullivan with a slim lead over Vinny Atria. 11 pins of deficit. We'll be back right after this. Sponsors, Doug Anthrop, Shell, Mr. Fence, and Cool Corals, Davies Auction, Star Grooming, and Awards Unlimited for making this tournament possible. Also want to thank AMF as they have donated Nighthawk shirts for all the bowling participants, as well as a Nighthawk bowling ball. Vinny Atria strikes in that sixth frame that even matched between him and Mark Sullivan. Also want to thank other sponsors, Holiday Inn, Schrader's Jewelry, D-Mark Refrigerated Specialties, Steel Rod CD Shop, and Electrolab. Sullivan looking and there is that nine pin. We have not seen that from him yet, but a lot from David Hurt in the first shootout round.
Yeah, without a doubt. He's throwing the ball really well, and he's got a tremendous roll on it. It's just coming in just a little high, and he's not getting the break he deserves.
Well, that's what we're talking about, with the ball finishing so hard, the ball is driving past him. As Terry Clayton steps up, and he's spared. That ball goes through the nose.
That was fortunate
to be, yes, fortunate to be the 6-10. Well, you know, Terry last year ran the ladder against the opponents last year. He went from the fourth seed to win the tournament. He was the eighth seed here, and he is attempting to try to do the same thing this year. Although the tournament leader Gary Ness will have something to say about that, I'm sure.
Oh, without a doubt. I don't expect Mr. Ness to win down for him.
Sullivan makes his spin, and ooh, Terry Clayton takes the 10 off the 6. Open frame for Terry. Things do not look good for Terry Clayton this year.
Yeah, Terry looks a little bit out of it right now. It's a grueling format. Sometimes the player gets tired mentally, and you make a mistake.
Well, Vinny Atria with a double working here in the 7th frame, looking to take a commanding 21-pin lead over Mark Sullivan.
Nice roll.
Oh, he trips him up. Nice heavy hit. Knocks the 9-pin down late. So Vinny Sullivan takes a 21-pin lead. He has a three-layer now working. So he's forced Mark Sullivan to step up here and throw a strike here in the 7th frame.
Vinny's got a little bit of a different ball roll. It's more end over end, so he can play it a little high flush and not leave it a 4-pin or a 9-pin.
Looking for the ball to finish, and it does. Nice shot from Mark Sullivan. Because that lead is now down to 20 pins against Vinny Atria. Terry Clayton open in the 6th frame. You want to note also that Mark Sullivan defeated Joel Moulton by 603 to 529 to make the TV show. Terry Clayton swishes the pocket for a strike here in the 7th frame. Big shot for Terry Clayton. Also, Vinny Atria defeated a talented left-hander, Jerry Schultz, 675 to 599 to earn the number 2 seed here.
Yeah, Vinny bowled tremendous. I mean, 675 on this lane condition is just phenomenal bowling. So they have to remind people, this is not your typical lead shot.
Vinny
Dimitri with the three banger. He is in command right now, leading by 20 pins.
Very meticulous.
Solid 10 pin for Vinny, and he wanted that shot, but you could tell by his facial expression after he left it. So now the door is wide open for Mark Sullivan, as he is down 19. He can get it within 9 pins with a strike here.
Nice and soft.
Oh, beauty shot. Once again, he leads a 10 pin. So back-to-back 10 pins here by Sullivan and Atria. As the lead now creeps back up.
It looks to me like Mark made a bit of an adjustment. He went high a little bit, and then he went flush, and then 10 pins. But he made the right move.
Then he will go back to 10 pin. Ooh, boy, that was close. He's shaking his head. He wasn't for sure he made it yet either. And he was saying, look out there, as Mark Sullivan will attempt to make his 10 pin to stay in the match here. And he makes it.
So when you have a difficult lane conditions and you're not quite getting the carry, you've got to make the squares.
Well, Terry Clayton, he has to strike. He is down 33 pins in this match. Trying to cut it to 23 here with the strike. In the eighth frame. With any chance of staying alive, he must have this one. And he gets it. So I tell you what, as soon as you think he is done, he sneaks right back in there. So big shot for Terry Clayton. In the eighth frame.
Terry's got a great memory game. He knows how to relax. He knows how to get himself back into it and with a quality shot. You've got to beat Terry Clayton. He very rarely loses to you.
Well, Vinny Adrian with a spare work in the eighth, needing a strike here to maintain his 9-pin lead over Mark Sullivan. Speaking of Mark Sullivan, he has been bowling for many years, and his career high set is 26 as Vinny Adrian strikes in the ninth frame. And he has a high game of 300. Matter of fact, he's bowled 10 of them. So all these guys are very well accomplished. 35 years from Indianapolis, Indiana. And Vinny Atria, 54 from Louisville, Kentucky, has done so many things. It's amazing. Sullivan will...
I'll get a break.
Oh, it won't fall. It's a 10-pin, just sisters and wiggles.
And that's going to make things interesting, because Vinny right now, he's just a consummate shot maker, and he's not giving away the pocket.
Well, Sullivan, with this fair, will still trail by 10. But now, Terry can cut this lead down when he's right here with a double. He's got a double working in the ninth frame. Double right to the nose, and Terry Clayton's day is finished. And Sullivan to stay in the match to make the 10, and he will. So Mark Sullivan here still has a chance. This match is not over by any stretch of the imagination. Vinny Atria working on a 205 pace. Sullivan can strike out for 205, so we have another possibility for a tie. As Terry misses the 3-6-10, he'll leave the 10 pin. So Terry Clayton, 147-9. His day is finished, but still a good run for Terry Clayton as he wins two matches to move up the ladder. He'll finish fourth in this tournament.
Didn't quite make it all the way like he did last year, but still an outstanding finish for a fine bowler.
This to win the turn, win this third shootout round for Vinny Atria. Strike will lock out Mark Sullivan. And he got it. And man, he was excited about it too. And that will lock the door out on Mr. Sullivan from Indianapolis, Indiana.
So he never gave away the pocket.
Well, Sullivan, everything is over. He knows it's done. He'll leave the 3-10 split. What a solid game for Vinny Atria. As both players, Sullivan and Atria, were throwing the ball well, and neither one really could carry consistently. But Vinny did when he needed it.
Yep.
Vinny Atria with another strike. That's a three-bagger now. He's on a 220 pace, and it's all academic here as Vinny will vie for the tournament title once again.
Vinny's back in it. So a consummate shot maker like him, he's never really out of it. As long as he's playing his game, throwing the ball smooth, he's always going to have a chance.
I tell you what, Vinny Atria has accomplished so many things in the realm of bowling. He has won a mini eliminator. He has won the pointy several times. He's won the super. He has like 19 medals bowling for Team USA. He's been a Team USA member at least a half a dozen times. So Vinny is excellent amateur bowler.
Oh, yes. He's got a very simple game. have to rub it hard to score well.
Voila!
You just have to get yourself a game where you can repeat shot after shot, and that's what Vinny has, without a doubt.
Well, Terry Clayton will finish here in the 10th frame, and he'll throw a strike, and they always fall when you're out of the match, don't they?
Yeah, it's easy to loosen up and get a good carry.
It's amazing the fact that when you're going in league, you need the first one in the 10, you know, and you leave a solid corner pin, and then you throw the field ball when it doesn't matter, just stand in the pit.
Oh, it's funny how it works out that way. You always get the shakers off the wall when it doesn't count for anything.
I just don't know if you're more loose or if you just kids know that you don't care right now.
Yeah, I'm about to say that.
Once again, we'll thank our sponsors, Doug Anthrop Show, Mr. Fence at Cool Coral, Stavey's Auction, Star Grooming, Awards Unlimited, Holiday Inn, Dean Hart's Refrigerated Specialties, Straight Up Jewelry, Steel Rod CB Shop, The Electro Lab, Nirvana Family Restaurant, and Holiday and AMF. As Terry Clayton goes down here to Vinny Atria, who wins it 223 over Mark Sullivan, 193, and Terry Clayton's 167. We'll be back with a championship match between Gary Ness and Vinny Atria right after this.
And we are back, and in the last match, Vinny Atria shot a 223 to prevail over Mark Sullivan's 193 and Terry Clayton's 167. And on the lanes right now is Scott Gilmore with Terry Clayton.
All right, here we're here with last year's winner, Terry Clayton. And Terry, you were the 4th seed in last year's tournament. You won the title. You were the 8th seed in this year's tournament. You came up short. Describe what kind of changes the lanes were making and what you tried to do to adjust to them.
I think there was two things going on out there. Several of us are playing the same line, the outside line. And I think the ball is taking up some of the oil, and therefore they're drying out a little bit. The other thing that's taking the play here, too, is that I was probably getting just a little tired, maybe, and a little soft on some of those shots, and it's coming up high.
Well, as a matter of fact, you bowled 6 games prior to the TV show and bowled 2 more on the TV show, so I'm sure you were a little bit tired there. And did that have a real effect on how you performed in that last match?
Oh, I think so, especially in the legs. The legs are so important in the game of bowling, the push-off, the leverage, and everything like that. And I think I just wasn't staying down with the shots, getting a little soft, and coming high.
Well, you finished third this year, and we'll see you next year.
Oh, yeah, great tournament, great tournament. I'll be back.
All right, that was Terry Clayton. And now I'm here with the tournament sponsor, Spiro Moises, owner of Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. And, Spiro, you have to be happy with how things are going so far.
Well, things are going great. This is a great tournament, and bowling is just a great game for whole family. And I just love it.
Well, you bowled in the tournament, so you know how hard the condition was that these players are bowling on right now.
It was. Chad did a great job on conditioning the lanes to make a tough shot on everybody. And I give credit to most of these bowlers over here that made it to the finals with the great scores, because it's so difficult to bowl on the lane conditions like that. It's a great job.
Well, we want to thank you for your contributions, and we'll get on with this championship match. Back to you, Doug.
Okay, we are ready for the championship match, which is going to feature Vinny Atria bowling against our tournament leader, Gary Ness. And without a doubt, we have two outstanding bowlers in this final. I had the misfortune of running into Gary Ness, and he schooled me without a doubt.
And made it back up here to our booth as Vinny will start this championship match and trips the 3-pin late to only leave a 6-pin. So a big match here for the title. Winner will receive $1,300. Loser will receive $800. Terry Clayton, excuse me, finished 4th for $400.
Yeah, we have a fine prize fund. These bowlers are bowling for a decent amount of cash. And I'm wondering if the breaks that we have with commercials and team matches may affect Vinny a little bit.
Vinny missed the 6-pin bad, and you just do not want to give tournament leader Gary Ness any opening whatsoever. It's Gary Ness, I don't want to use steamroll over you in the 3-game elimination match, but he jumped out on you early,
yep.
And he has bowled good all weekend long.
Yeah, without a doubt, he's got a great line on the lane, and he's throwing the ball so well.
Was his first shot of the match.
Watch the roll.
Oh, and he trips the 6-pin. And I tell you what, do you feel, even though Vinny has a game under his belt,
the right side had much more bowlers on it than the left side. Only one lefty other than Gary Ness making the TV show. So yeah, does he have an advantage with that?
It may be in a situation where the right-hand part of the lane is now going to get a little bit what we call squirrely, because we have had so many right-handed bowlers, and there's nobody on the left side to roll the lane out. So once Ness finds his line, there should be no reason why it will change within the course of a single game.
This tournament is very important to Gary Ness, as he would like to keep the title in Lafayette, Indiana, as he is from Lafayette, Indiana. Next one, what a standing shot as Gary opens with a double here. And I tell you what, when it comes to bowling tournaments in this county, he owns this county.
It seems like no matter what house that he bowls in, all around this local area, he's got a chance to win almost every time.
Gary Ness is high set of 838. He has four 300s to his count. Vinny Atria will step up here in the second. Needing a five if he gets it. Do not count Vinny Atria out.
No,
by no means.
I said, I think the break, he got a little stiff after the break, didn't quite get to the shot, but he's going to loosen up now. A little bit quicker format, only two players. And no, without a doubt, Vinny's going to make some quality shots from here on out.
Well, Gary Ness, a safety technician at Eli Lilly. We asked him early on before this tournament TV show started, what would you plan on doing with the money if you won? He said, do a little Christmas shopping.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are going to be doing that at this time of year.
All right, Vinny needing a double here to cut it to the post across the head pin, leaving the 6-10 once again. So Vinny is not lined up yet.
No, lane 17 may be going away a little bit faster than he's ready to adjust for.
We asked Vinny what he would do with the money after, if he won the tournament. He said he'd spend a little bit of it on his wife's birthday, which is December 15th. We want to wish her a happy early birthday, as Vinny converts the 6-10. So, Gary Ness leading by 23 pins early on in this match. Looking to extend that to 33. And I tell you what, I've seen a lot of bowling, and the condition that he was bowling on, he bowled about as fine as anybody I've seen.
Without a doubt, he just, every shot was in play. He never let the ball really get away from him. He never gave away the head.
And he's shot in the third. And it is
too strong.
It's heavy, leaving the eighth pin. Told himself a good ball, it was. So he'll leave the eighth pin here in the third, leading by 20 over Vinny Atria. Wants to send a special thanks to Spiro Moises, owner of the Nirvana Band Restaurant, not only for his contribution to the tournament, but he would also like to thank him for his community service. And Spiro always hosts a Thanksgiving meal for the people that are not as fortunate as others, the ones that are homeless. And we'd like to thank him, as, you know, that's really special when we have people out there helping the community.
Oh, Spiro's a quality guy. I've liked him ever since I first met him 6-7 years ago. And great sense of family, great sense of community. And he's obviously a very generous sponsor all around.
Gary with the spare in the third. In the fourth. Looks like a good shot. Comes up a little light, leaving the three pin. He'll say, okay, anytime you miss and you only leave one pin, that's not so bad.
Yeah, he got away with one that was a little bit less than what he liked. But a pretty simple spare for him to make. That's a shot of spare.
Well, there's Spiro Moises right there. That's what we were talking about. Interviewed him just a few minutes ago, and he's a wonderful man to talk to. I really enjoy him.
Oh, I always like getting together with him every Monday night.
As Gary will commit the three pin, and he'll miss it, and a costly spare. I don't know if he was looking at the cameraman and roving around, if he was disturbed. I don't know. He was shaking his head, looking to his right.
That's quite possible. So this television format is unusual for most bowlers. There's a lot of distractions in the background and off to the side.
And he's sitting up striking in the fourth. And, you know, once we're thinking up here, he's kind of opened the door back for Vinny.
Yeah, so Vinny's a little bit more used to it, besides making last year's finals for this event. He has also bowled some televised finals, I believe, with the World Team Challenge. So he's got a little bit more television experience, and so a little bit of disturbances to the side or in the background not going to affect him quite as much.
Yes, he is. As a matter of fact, he also won a million eliminator, which the finals of that are bowled on television out in Las Vegas. So
He's accustomed to the TV lights and cameras, so a little bit of advantage there if you're thinking Benny Atrium. And his shot in the back and almost leaves a 7-10. Fortunately, it just a 10, but he didn't like it. Just didn't release it quick.
No, it hit the lane a little hard. Looked like he got around it a little bit early, and he got it wide enough, but it didn't have any kick at the back end to trip the fence.
Also want to thank Ron Hicklin for doing our Tip of the Week sponsored by AMF. Always a pleasure to see Ron Hicklin and discuss bowling technologies. He knows about as much as anybody that I've ever met, as Vinny Adrian misses a 10 pin. Unbelievable. I have never seen Vinny Adrian miss two spares in one game.
I think maybe getting into the final match. No, this is a long tournament for everybody. 8 games on Saturday, 3 more games to cut to the 16, then 3 more. And now you got to get through this very difficult final.
Well, Gary Ness, licking his chops, I'm sure, as he opened it before, looking to redeem himself. He gets it out wide, and he's going to get a lucky domino effect, is what we call it. He's thinking, you know, if I would have tripped the seventh in, I'd have had that domino strike.
No, that's no backdoor play.
Almost got a backdoor there, but leaving the seventh in. And I tell you what, he has got to feel very fortunate right there. He'll go at the seventh in.
Nope.
Uh-oh, he missed it. I tell you what, I think it's just nerves.
I think the players are a little tight.
Well, Benny Adrian's got to be like, wow.
Yeah.
I can't believe I missed a 10 pin, which I probably missed more in the last 10 years. And Gary missed a 7 pin, giving me right back in the match.
I think it's going to come down to which player can collect his thoughts this second half.
On the 6th frame, Gary working on an open. And he throws a dandy strike there in the 6th. Big shot for Gary as he leads by 9 early on, halfway through this match. For the 1999 Nevada Family Restaurant Open.
That was a very aggressive shot. Gary gave himself a little kick, but was disappointed in missing that spare, and really, really threw a quality shot.
Well, we also like to thank some more sponsors, Holiday Inn, D-Mark's Refrigerator Specialties, Strader's Jewelry, Steel Rod CB Shop, Electro Lab, Star Grooming, Davies Auctions, Cool Corals, Mr. Fencer, Thug Anthem Show, and Awards Unlimited, and also AMF. And Benny was disturbed by something there, and I'm not too sure it was the cameraman or what, but maybe it was just speed when he's going on, because he knows this is a critical shot.
Yeah, Vinny's going to be very, very careful getting himself set up. He's going to make sure he feels absolutely comfortable with this ball.
Here it is, down 9. Moving the strike to keep pressure on Gary Ness. Oh, he grabs a 10 pin, and that is back-to-back 10s for Vinny Adrian. And I tell you what, most of the players, you know, anytime you bowl a lot of games, you're physically tired, but then when you're bowling under pressure for so long, you're mentally tired as well. It's just exhaustion on a player.
You better believe it. I mean, I know from my own experience, you know, I can bowl 10 games in a row, but it's no big deal. You bowl 10 games in a pressure situation like this, and suddenly, you know, you're ready to go home and collapse because you just mentally, you're so worn out.
Well, Benny makes the pin, man. And Doug, you also teach classes at Purdue University. You teach a bowling class downstairs in the unit now. So you're accustomed to the technology and what it takes to make good shots, so.
Yeah, the players that you see here have simple games. They have games that allow you great shot repetition.
And here's Vinny Adrian again, the 7th pin, and he goes through the nose, leaving the 6th pin, and he is lost on that left lane.
Yeah, he's just not getting the ball down the lane with any confidence. I don't know if he wants to move in and play in more inside line. It does not seem that this current line is going to get him the ball down to the break line where he wants.
Well, Benny trying to make a 10 pin, the 6th pin, and he missed that. I cannot believe this. I don't think I've ever seen Benny Adrian miss two spares in one game. Especially 7th spares. Something is not right there.
No, I think the players are a little bit distracted, a little mentally worn out.
Here's Gary Ness with a strike in the 6th, almost really put some hurt. And he swept that
too.
Left.
Yep.
And both players are lost.
Well, I don't know so much they're lost in terms of the lane conditions. Maybe Vinny is on the odd lane. But they're just not making real quality shots at this point. We're going to have a bit of a a struggle getting here to the end of the match.
Well, anytime you go for $2,100, 13 for first, for second, it's going to make you squeeze a little bit too, as well as Gary converts the 1-3-5.
So we're bowling under an unusual lane, under condition in terms of television finals. We're bowling for a decent amount of cash. You know, this isn't pocket cash, without a doubt.
I tell you what, that 1-3-9 conversion is not an easy conversion, so.
And you have to come across the face of the head pin to make the spare. If you throw a strike ball, you won't get to the back pin.
And he not winning the book there, Gary shot, as he's looking to find a focus on making a quality shot when he's up there. He's very on spare, very needy. And he leaves a swishing 10 pin, and when the conditions are tough, and you are tight, not only physically but mentally, it is hard to make a good shot and then carry.
Yes, it becomes difficult to execute, because, you know, the brain's in control of the body, and if the brain's a little tired and you don't quite feel the rhythm, the ball won't come off the hand the same every time.
Well, Gary is trying to make the 10 pin here.
Oh, there we go.
And the crowd applauses. Right now, spares are a premium, and making quality shots is a premium in this kind of condition. Chad Lester has done a phenomenal job taking care of the lanes this weekend for this tournament. Very well run. Much of the players are happy with how things have went. And once again, Vinny backs off the approach, saying something to Gary, not for sure what it is. I don't know if something is bothering him or what.
He may not feel very comfortable right now. Something in the way the ball sets in the hand.
He's on one knee. He is.
Now that's a quality shot.
He is, just not for sure right now. And feel is everything in bowling, just like golf. If the ball does not feel right in your hand, you just will not make a call.
Yeah, you have no confidence in your ability to finish the swing and really drive through the back of the ball to get a heavy ball and maybe create some pin action.
Well, here's a scenario. He's down 20 to Gary, working on a strike in the eighth. We cut it to 10. Gary had a spare in the eighth, so this game is not over by any means. And Vinny, a good shot here, maybe? Yes, and that is what makes him good.
Yes.
You know, you look like you have him down, and all of a sudden he doubles, and he's right back in the match.
Well, it's what we call a low-maintenance game. You know, people who are coming up in the game, people who are learning a lot about the game, you don't need to torque it up, you don't need to rev it up, you don't need to throw it hard. Keep it simple, keep it in play.
We had several Purdue bowlers trying to make this TV field and came up short as Gary Ness leads the three pin. Scott Tucker and Ed Smadwick and Ron Hickman, who did our tip of the week, they all vied for a chance to make this TV show and came up short. And it's just one of those tournaments where you're going for big money and it's hard to focus on a tough condition sometimes.
Yep.
Well, here's the spare temp for Gary, and he'll make it. And here's the scenario once again. Well, Gary has 144 in the game. His maximum score is 194. Then Adrian can shoot strike out for 195. We have a potential for another tie.
For another tie, yeah. Then he goes double nine count, assuming that Gary performs here in the 10th.
So a strike here will force Vinny to at least mark. He goes through the nose, Gary does here, first ball on the 10th.
I think he rushed that. I think he really wanted it so bad. Yeah, he didn't make the quality shot he wanted to.
So Vinny will have to step up, I believe, and throw the first one in the 10th to win this match. Yes, and Gary makes a spare, so that forces Vinny, I believe, Doug, to strike the first one in the 10th to win the 1999 Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. Same scenario it was in last year. Strike to win, 9 to tie. He got 8 and lost to Gary Clayton, 203 to 202. So Vinny's going to have all the pressure. This is the big shot. You need to get maximum fill here.
Oh, that was not the fill he was looking for.
Oh, and that's going to give him 179. If Vinny throws 9 spare, that would be 134, 154.
70.
He has to strike.
He has Tough to strike.
Yes, he does. Strike puts him in 180.
Yep. Spare will not be good enough.
It's 170 or a little, and he cannot win this title. It's a huge shot. This is for the match. In the 1999, the public fan, must strike situation. Here's the ball.
It's a good shot.
Oh, goes through the nose, and he leaves a 6-10. And I tell you what, Gary Ness will win the 1999 Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. Unbelievable.
When he let go of it, I thought it was a pretty good shot.
And Vinny Atria, once again, will finish second. And I'm telling you what, he's bowled so well every year he's come here, and he's come up short. He lost to Terry Clayton last year by 10. He's going to lose probably to Gary Ness by 6. So, unfortunate for Vinny Atria, but he'll be back, I'm sure. Oh, and he'll cherry pick that six off the 10, but
bit of a disappointing finish for him that time.
I'm sure. Gary Ness, our 1999 Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. We'll be back with player interviews, the trophy, and a check right after this. All right, welcome back to Star Lanes here, and our 1999 champion, Gary Ness. I'm joined with Holly Conrad, owner of Star Lanes, and Spiro Moisett is owner of Nirvana Family Restaurant, and with the check presentation here, Spiro.
Gary, congratulations on behalf of Star Lanes and Nirvana Restaurant and all the restaurant sponsors for the great bowling for the fall weekend. Here's a $1,200 check.
Thank you, Spiro. I appreciate everything you do for that and the community also.
Thank you.
All right, here's the owner of Star Lanes, Holly Conrad, and she'll present Gary Ness with the 1999 Winner's Trophy and $101 bills that are inside. And I tell you what, it was a great match between Gary and Vinny as both players struggled on the championship pair, and it was kind of a dogfight there at the end. And Gary, you said you struggled in practice early on. What adjustments did you make throughout the match to kind of pull this victory out?
Not the right ones, evidently, because 179 is not the games we were shooting earlier. And obviously, Vinny's a much better bowler on the spare shooting than he was in that game, and he had a back problem. So I hope I didn't back into it, so to speak. But, you know, neither one of us performed real well. But, you know, it's a challenging condition, and it's a new experience for me.
Well, I noticed you bowled well throughout the whole weekend. I mean, you were the leading qualifier going in. You had to win your match against Doug Weedman, who did color with us today. But what was so different about the championship pair? Do you think it might have been the TV lights or whatever?
No, it just seemed like the ball hooked a lot sooner than it did down on the other condition that we qualified on, and it was just really hard to adjust. And I think everybody had similar problems with it. It's just that, well, I just never really got lined up. So I was freewheeling it, hoping to make a few spares, and missed a couple, but got enough, I guess.
Well, this whole weekend was based on making quality shots, and they were premium, and you did that throughout the weekend. So you probably deserve to win this, don't you think?
Thanks, I guess.
Well, our 1999 winner, Gary Ness from Lafayette, Indiana. And we'll wrap things up. And, Doug, I tell you what, it was an exciting TV field, a lot of experience, and it was kind of neat to see another Lafayette guy come out here on top.
Well, it's good. We have a lot of quality bowlers in this area, and it's, you know, it's nice to see them come through. Throughout this state, you know, you have a lot of great bowlers. It was a tough finish. When you have a challenging lane condition, it comes down to spare shooting. Whoever keeps their head and makes their spares are probably going to prevail.
Well, you hate to hear that a back injury might have kept Vinny Atria from winning this tournament, but you have to feel that Gary Ness deserved to win. He was a tournament leader, and he came out on top.
Oh, without a doubt. Gary made quality shot after quality shot all through Saturday into Sunday morning. He almost lapped the field in terms of the number of great games that he bowled.
Plus, we want to thank all of our sponsors as well, the Nirvana Family Restaurant Open, AMF, Holiday Inn, Steel Rod, CB Shop, Schrader's Jewelry, Electrolab, and all the others that have joined us on board for this 1999 Nirvana Family Restaurant Open. We want to see everybody next year. So long, everybody.